هذا بإذن الله سبحانه وتعالى. الشكر والصلاة بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. صلى الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يتقبل منا وإياكم صالح الأعمال. اللهم أمين. We're still talking about the thousand ways, inshallah, will lead us to the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to paradise. من هم السبعون ألف الذين يدخلون الجنة بغير حساب. We have that hadith which is Imam Muslim narrated. He said 70,000 of the Ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam will enter paradise, Jannah, without any measure, without any accountability in the day of judgment. May Allah make all of us amongst them, inshallah. That hadith, which is Imran ibn Husayn, radiallahu anhu, narrated, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يدخل الجنة من أمتي سبعون ألفا بغير حساب ولا عذاب. قيل من هم؟ قال هم الذين لا يسترخون ولا يكتوون ولا يتطيرون وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. That Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, which is Imran ibn Husayn narrated, that said, amongst my ummah, 70,000 of my ummah, my followers, will enter paradise without any accountability, without measures, without hisab. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, tell us about them. This is the way of the Sahaba. Sahaba, they were so anxious to get knowledge from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, subhanAllah, yes, brothers, 70,000 will enter Jannah without any accountability. MashaAllah, good. Jazakallah khair. But Sahaba, they were different. Ya Rasulullah, tell us about the quality of these people. Aywa, this is a way. Now the question, bring another question now. Aywa, what tell us about the quality of these people? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, first type of this ummah, of these people, لا يسترقون. You know, if somebody gets sick, which is not haram at all. If you get sick, you ask for ruqya from somebody, or you can make ruqya to yourself too, for your kids. Ruqya means to go to doctor. This is, you ask for ruqya. Or to go to sheikh, he can make ruqya for you, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, some dua, some ayat. Or you can do it yourself too. If you know the hadith of Rasulullah and the du'as and all of that of ruqya, you can do it yourself. But these people, when they get sick, that doesn't need, you know, all of this. Why? Because they have full tawakkul ala Allah. They trust Allah 100%. Ya Rabbi, we don't need anything from. But to be honest with you, some Muslims, they misunderstand this hadith nowadays. One of these types of Muslims, yani. I can tell you Sufi. Yani. Why you have to hide it? Yani. What is it? Please let me tell you. A Sufi. One of them, look what the shatat they have going away. One of them said, if you go to your doctor, and they give you medicine, this is shirk. Shirk? How do you know that? He said, yes, because now you are taking this medicine and you'll go to this doctor and you think the doctor is going to cure your illness and Allah is not. This is shirk. No. If you get sick, die like this, don't go to the doctor. This is against Islam. Completely against Islam. And you know, this is shut up, you know? SubhanAllah. This is not right at all. No, you have to. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ جَعْلَ لِكُلِّ دَيْءٍ دَوَاءً فَتَدَاوَوْا. You know, if you get sick, go to your doctor, ask for medicine, you know. تَدَاوَوْا, he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that. But these people, they have very high iman. They never ask for ruqya, but they ask Allah for shifa. Yes, and I think this is better. Beginning, ask Allah for shifa. And of course, follow the means, and you can get, inshallah, shifa, doctor, medicine, whatever. ولا يكتوون الكي also like medicine during that time because سيدنا جبريل when he advised the رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم he said يا محمد the شفاء the cure of your أمة in three things number one قال في شربة عسل if you drink honey pure honey that شفاء in it في شفاء للناس الله said in the Quran number two في ضربة محجن ضربت محجن, you know, that they call it nowadays cupping. الحجامة, يعني. That hadith said, الحجامة. That, you know, they put cups like this in the pain, and I like this so much. I make it like six times. Alhamdulillah, I never became يعني, sick because not out of sickness. I do it just to follow the sunnah. I make it five times or six times. And I make it here, I make it in my back. When I was 23 years even, I started doing that. But just to follow the sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. But this is very good. This, you know, Al-Hijama like what? I have experience in it. Al-Hijama, exactly. Rasulullah did it 9 times. He did it, Rasulullah, 9 times, Al-Hijama. Al-Hijama like vacuum. You know the vacuum? If you have a lot of blood under your skin, and this is not in the, you know, the vein, you know, under the skin. This is just load in your body, you know? And this is too much because we are fat now, we are eating, we are not walking, we are not taking this out. فالحجامة subhanAllah, like a vacuum. Sucking all of this, throw it away. And Rasulullah did it 9 times. And I feel it. When I used to make it, oof, I feel like I'm light, very light. You know, subhanAllah, you see this and you see that, khalas. You didn't need to go to the doctor for tajmeel to fix your face, to fix it. No, it's fixed already, khalas. Just vacuum. Take it away, khalas, yalla, throw it in the trash. This is load in your body. Rasulullah did it 9 times. And the last one when he ate from the boys and sheep that Jewish lady invited him for it, he made one called Al-Mughitha. Al-Mughitha, even he called it the name of it, Al-Hijam. Al-Mughitha, he make it in the middle of his head like this. He could suck the blood from this area. That blood is not coming from the vein, from the body, from the heart. No, it's all the skin, under the skin, you know. But the point is, and they said number 3, Al-Kayya Binar. They used to, somebody sick, they used to, with the fire, they used to. And he said, Wala uhibbu an aktabi, I don't like this, because the one who's punishing you with fire, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why I don't like it. Wala uhibbu an aktawi. He said, La yastarquna wala yaktawun, number 3, Wala yatatayarun. At-tiyara, this is shirk, haram. For example, tiyara means the people of Mecca or the kuffar before, they used to get some birds, for example. They used to say, okay, if we let these birds fly, if they go to the right this way, the rain is going to come. If they go this way, the rain is not coming. And this is shirk, haram. They used to fly it like this. If the bird goes this way, khalas, the rain is coming. If it's going that way, no rain, not today. You know, like the people nowadays, they said, it's luck, you're lucky, brother. I don't like this word, this is haram. Don't say you're lucky. Who's you're lucky or not lucky? Allah, everything in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or all of our affairs. Then say, don't forget this word luck. I hear it too much from you. You're lucky. What's so lucky? Lucky. You know? This is like a tira, somehow. The same thing. For Rasulullah said, لا يسترقون ولا يكتوون ولا يتطيرون. In the end, وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. More you depend on Allah. You trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. SubhanAllah, they call it self-sufficient. Most of the people now, because they have money, they have job, they have whatever, education, they have the, khalas, he think he's getting his money from his job. Khalas, he depends on his job. He's not depending on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why this is haram, you know. You have to depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not your job or your education or your business. This is Allah gave it to you, he can take it, you know. He is the one that is Razzaq. Do you have any doubt Allah is Razzaq? No doubt. Allah is the one who's giving risk. That's why tawakkul ala Allah. And there are too many ahadith about that. Rasulullah said, لو أنكم تتوكلون على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير تغدو خمسة وتروح بطال. If you really 100% you trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wallahi he will give you rizq like the bird. In the morning, subhanAllah, the bird flying, empty stomach. But they came back with full stomach. Who gave them that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will give you rizq like them. But trust Allah. And follow the means of risk also. Don't sit and say, I'm waiting for the gold, the silver. No, you have to work too. Follow the means of getting risk and ask Allah, Allah will give it to you. These types of this ummah, from our ummah, inshallah, they will enter Jannah without any accountability. And another hadith said, with each person of this 70, another 70,000, they will enter Jannah without accountability. You got it? We have 70,000. Types of the ummah, some of these characteristics right here, qualities. And they said with each one of them, I read another hadith said, with each one of the 70,000, another 70,000 with each person of this 70, they will enter Jannah without any accountability. If you 70,000 times with each one, 70, how much am I?
49,000,000.
Yani, inshallah, the most, yani, all the ummah, inshallah.
Like billions.
Inshallah. Means all the ummah will enter Jannah, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. I read that hadith also, subhanAllah.
It's going to be 49,000,000.
And we'll end with this hadith today, Saturday. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-afuna ala al-nasi yadkhuluna al-jannah. If you forgive others, Allah will enter the Jannah. Afu, khalas. Al-afu, take what? Al-afu is not forgiveness, even. Al-afu is bitter. العفو يعني الصفح ربنا الله سبحانه وتعالى said that in the Quran فاصفح الصفح الجميل. When you forgive somebody, don't blame him.
لما قال الصبر الجميل، وهذا القرآن الصبر الجميل والصفح الجميل. لايك العفو، لايك سيدنا يوسف عليه السلام، رافت يوسف. When his brothers came to Egypt and he told them who was he and a lot of tears. Remember? He did that to me, he did that, he did that, he did that, blaming, blaming. And then he said, اليوم يغفر الله لكم. خلاص. You just go. I don't want to hurt you. You're my brothers, you know. And also Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he was in Mecca, open Mecca. Hey, what are you going to do to us, Rasulullah? Are you going to kill us today? What do you think? He asked them, what do you think, what are you going to do to you? Subhanallah. They knew him, his family, they knew his akhlaq, his manners. Even they've been against him all of their life. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, idhhabu fa antum at-tulaqa. This is afa. Imagine somebody, 20 years, is trying to kill you. He's not leaving you alone. So he immigrated, he sent the sahaba twice to Abyssinia. And he immigrated to Medina. He just left them alone. He went to Taif, escaping from them. Subhanallah, they did not leave him alone. They follow him, Badr, Uhud, Al-Ahzab. They plot against him a lot. 20 years they tried to kill him. And just like this, you go. Who can do that? Subhanallah, just Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can do that. For that's why al-afu. Let's see the hadith here. Kana sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال في حديث ابن عباس قال صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كان يوم القيامة نادى مناد يا قوم أين العافون عن الناس هلموا لربكم وخذوا أجوركم وحق على كل امرئ مسلم إذا عفى أن يدخل الجنة. الله أكبر. In the day of judgment there is a caller while people in trouble standing, and that caller was going to say, where are those who used to forgive others والعافين عن الناس والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين. Where are these types of people, the color could be. And if somebody about used to forgive people, you, I'm here, I'm there, I'm there, come. You come to this side. Huh? Why? They're going to stay alone. Come take your word from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. على رؤوس الأشهاد. يعني إيه تعرفي على رؤوس الأشهاد. Imagine that all mankind, jinn and the ins standing 50,000 years, and suddenly while you are in the struggle, standing long, and somebody's calling you, you please, you used to forgive others, you come this side, forget this, come this side. Why? Why are you calling us? Now you have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is keeping a reward for you. Everybody's watching. Al-Rus al-Ashhad, watching. Al-Rus al-Ashhad, Aina al-Afuna al-Nas? Where are those who used to forgive others? Come this side. Take your word from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَحَقٌ عَلَى كُلِّ امْرِئٍ مُسْلِمٍ. حق على كل امرئ مسلم means like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it's a due, so لازم, it's a fard for himself. Anybody used to forgive others, he will enter Jannah, and يدخل الجنة. Subhanallah. That's why the Quran said that. والكاظمين الغيظة, those when they get angry, you know, what they used to do? They swallow their anger, والكاظمين الغيظة, and they used to forgive others. There are too many stories really about that, but no time, inshallah, I don't want to make it long. جزاكم الله خير, maybe tomorrow we'll continue. بارك الله فيكم. That's awesome.